National Institutes of Health, National Cancer Institute, Merging Hints Data, Introduction.
Hello, I'm Rick Moser, lead hints methodologist at the National Cancer Institute, and in this video series, I'll be showing you how to merge multiple iterations of hints data for your statistical analyses. Why would you want to merge two or more sets of hints data? There are two really good use cases for this. The first is to examine trends over time. Because of common sampling procedures, we can consider each hints iteration as an independent sample of the non-institutionalized U.S. adult population 18 and older. There are different people in each iteration, of course, but the iterations still serve as a collection of similar independent samples. Thus, you can merge them together and look at patterns over time. The other use case scenario would be to combine the data together to get a larger sample size. This can be very useful, specifically if you're interested in a particular subgroup within hints respondents, for example, racial or ethnic subgroups, and there aren't enough respondents in one data set to give you stable estimates of your outcome. To do this, however, you must assume that your outcomes of interest do not change significantly over time. You still merge the data together, but you will analyze the data set as a whole. Now, before we get into the detail about the code used here, I'd like to provide an overview of what we're doing within SAS to merge and analyze these data. The first part of this code is basically going to create a format that we're going to apply to a new variable called survey. We'll add survey to each data set in the subsequent steps. This variable will distinguish between iterations for comparison purposes. The second set of code here, the data/set statements, assigns the variable survey to each iteration, which will help us determine the origin of each respondent and allow you to compare iterations. The code down here is setting up your weights correctly. There will be one final sample weight from each iteration that we will merge. The number of replicate weights will be 50 times k, where k is the number of iterations you are merging together. Finally, once you have everything merged together through this data statement, we'll be ready to run our statistical procedures. In this five-part tutorial series, I'll show you how to merge two or more hints data iterations in your statistical analyses. In video 2, I'll show you how to create the indicator variables and assign values. In video 3, we'll review how to assign weights and create a new merged data set. In videos 4 and 5, we'll review how to conduct a basic statistical analysis using that new merged data set and how to account for missing data during your analyses, respectively.
U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, National Institutes of Health, National Cancer Institute, cancer.gov, 1-800-4-CANCER, produced October 2018.